So once we see these two things next to each other, it kind of raises the question, why don't we just use a gradient descent type approach on an error metric that's defined in terms of y hat instead of just the activation A? Because y hat is the thing that we really want to match the output. We don't really want the activation to match the output. There's no need for that. So it seems like there's a bunch of different possible reasons for that. It could be, well, we don't do that because it would just be computationally intractable. It's too much work. Another possibility would be, well, to do the gradient descent, you have to be able to take the derivative, and if we use it in this form, it's not differentiable, so we can't take the derivative. Another one is, well, sure, we can do all that. It's not intractable, and it's not non-differentiable. It's differentiable. But if we do that, then the weights tend to grow too fast, and so you end up getting unstable answers. And then the last possible choice that we'll give you is you can do that, but you can get multiple different answers, and the different answers behave differently, and so this is really just to keep it from being ill-defined.